Good morning. It's super early and still dark outside, so I hope that the semi-color balance lighting in my bathroom will do justice to the beautiful beauty counter palette I'm about to demonstrate for you guys. I'm going to demonstrate the Winter Jewels palette today. I did a Facebook Live video last night of all of the beautiful sets of makeup that Beauty Counter has released yesterday for their seasonal or holiday collection. And all the makeup is absolutely gorgeous. I think there's like 88 new colors. So these are limited editions, and I'm gonna demonstrate that for you today. So far, what I've done this morning is I rough dried my hair, prepped my skin with my normal morning skincare routine. I used Dew Skin number 2 for my SPF, and I used Tint Skin in Linen. And so now I'm going to use my Touch Up Skin concealer pen in Fair. This is the lightest color. It's one shade lighter. You just click it down. It's one shade lighter than my actual skin color, which makes it perfect for a base for highlighting and contouring. I'm also gonna demonstrate the Illuminating Trio for you guys. It is also offered in the holiday collection. All right. So when you're concealing, and just really every day you can do this, or if you want it as a base for highlighting and contouring, you're going to do an inverted triangle here, an inverted triangle here, you do like an X or a cross here. One swipe down the bridge of your nose with a dash here. And then you do the Cupid's bow here and I really think this is called the philtrum. I should know that. I was a dental hygienist for like 13 years. So these are the areas in the front of your face that you're gonna highlight. And my favorite brush to blend with, you can also use a beauty blender, but I like this flat brush. I don't have a beauty blender right now. And instead of pulling the product, you can tap the product with the side of your brush and you get the same effect as if you had a silicone blender. Not only does this provide a base for highlighting and contouring, but it also gets rid of tired mommy eyes. Especially if you've prepped your eye area with the rejuvenating eye cream that Beauty Counter has with caffeine in it. I'm gonna leave this area right there. All right. Next up, I'm going to use the Illuminating Trio. I'm going to use Bronze Glow. When you're contouring your cheeks, you want to look at this area where the hair is. It pretty much will correspond to the top of your ear. And you're going to start here and imagine a line down to the corner of your mouth. I like to contour to the outside of my iris. So that's what we're gonna do here. Now I'm going to take this back in a triangle. I was going to try and sound smart and tell you what kind of triangle that is. I think it's isosceles. I'm going to do the same thing over here. So you don't need it to be very big because you're gonna blend it in. But let's talk about other areas that you want to contour in your face. So I always wear a fringe or bangs, so I don't normally contour up here. But if you don't, then this is a good place to contour your hairline right here. And so then you bring it down kind of like this. Another place you can contour is under your chin and stuff like that. I don't usually do that on a day-to-day basis, but I will tell you where I do contour: my nose. So I'm gonna look in this mirror over here, and I am going to just make a brown line against the white line that I'd already drawn. You're gonna do it down to like this area where your nostrils start to curve in. You can contour your nose lots of different ways. This is just how I do mine. And then I'm just gonna do like a couple little dots here. Okay. Now I'm going to use my flat complexion brush. So this is going to serve as a base. This is not going to be the only contour that we do. The Beauty Counter Illuminating Trio does have a little bit of shimmer to it, which I like. And it's enough that you can still see it once you fix your face with powder, but it's not so much that you go around looking glittery, which I think is kind of inappropriate for ladies my age. Next up, I'm going to use the Rose Glow. This is really a really sheer pink, so you don't have to be afraid of putting it on. So I'm gonna go back with blush later. So I'm just going to highlight. Basically, okay, so your contour went like this. Your blush is gonna go here, sort of, like that. Make sure that's even. And blend again. Okay. And next up, we are going to use our Pearl Glow. So it is the highlight. And highlight goes here. And here. Ooh, that came in pretty close. And then everywhere else that you put your white concealer, except for under your eyes. So we're gonna go here, here, and on the bridge of our nose. And blend again. there's really a lot of dimension coming out in your face now. All right, so before I fix my face with powder, I'm going to do my brows. I love the Beauty Counter brow pencils. So, if you've never done your brows before, or you do but you're not 100% sure how to do it, you want them to start kind of where the inside corner of your eye is. So you make a little mark there. And then do from the corner of your nose to the outside of your iris. That's where your arch is. Okay? And then from the corner of your nose to the outside corner of your eye is where your eyebrow ends. Just here. Okay. And then I think the easiest way to do it is to just draw a line on the top and draw a line on the bottom and color it in. Nothing super fancy there. And really what you're doing is you're not trying to make it look like hair. You're just creating a shadow. Just like you do with eyeshadow, you're just creating a shadow or the appearance of color. So, same thing here, we're gonna begin here, have an arch here, and end the brow here. My eyebrows are really asymmetrical. So this is kind of like sometimes I'll try to make them more even. They don't need to look exactly alike. Ta-da! All right, I'm gonna set my face. I am going to use my large powder brush. This is one of the brushes available in the Best of Brushes set from Beauty Counter right now. Okay. This is the translucent powder from Beauty Counter. I'm gonna tap and swirl in the lid. And I'm gonna start in the center of my face. And it does a great job of setting your makeup and making your makeup last. All right, now we're ready for the palette. I think I'm gonna do the pinks today. I have green, brown, hazel eyes, and so pink and purple tend to look really, really nice. So my two main brushes are gonna be this all-over eye brush and this crease brush. Both are available in the Best of Brushes set from Beauty Counter right now. And I watched Genevieve Blair's tutorial on eyeshadow the other day, and so I learned a few tricks from her. I think her YouTube channel is Jenny B Does Makeup or something like that. She's amazing. So, something that I learned from her is this is very pigmented. So, you're just going to tap in and then tap off. And then something that I never realized is that I forgot to prime my lid. Okay. So first you need to prime your lid with these to make them more blendable. So I'm going to use the Moonstone right in the middle. It is a matte or satin white, and since I'm pretty pale, putting a thin layer of this all over my eye is not gonna look super white. If you have darker skin, just any kind of matte shadow that is close to your skin color is gonna be fine. And this is going to make your eyeshadow more blendable. When you're working with more intense colors, that's what you want. Okay, so back to my all over brush right here. Although I don't know, I might switch to my crease brush, which is what I was just using. Okay, so I'm gonna tap into the rose quartz and tap off. And then Genevieve says, if you start where your crease is, not your crease, if you start where your arch of your eyebrow is and blend from there, you're gonna get a much better blend. So I had never done my crease colors first, or she calls them transition colors, but it makes a big difference as far as like how your eye looks. So this is my transition color here. You want to bring your transition color up pretty high. Because we're going to highlight the brow bone, and that's going to take it down some. All right, let's do the other side. So, how can you find time to do makeup if you're a busy mommy? Personally, I give my kid my phone. He loves to watch. I dropped my pen, my brush, sorry. Where'd it go? There it is. Okay. He loves to watch these channels on YouTube that I totally don't mind him watching. One is called Axel, the Axel Show, and it's this little kid and his dad, and his mom and his little sister too, and they're just all the time doing really, really cool stuff. I don't mind him watching it. He likes educational videos on there too. Okay, this is the dark color. Don't be scared. So I'm gonna put this in my crease. And I'm gonna do a V-shape here. Like so. You wanna bring your V out to this, like imagine a line here. Same thing on the other side. I never wore makeup for like, I don't know, a long time. And then I started using Beauty Counter, and it's just so much fun. I just love it so much. All right. I don't have a switching pan for my brushes. That would be optimal here. So I can use the inside of my arm. You can use paper towel too. So this looks dark, especially like for going to work. But remember, we're gonna blend several other colors in with this. So next, I'm gonna take my all-over brush that I had. I'm gonna take the shadow off of it. And I'm gonna go in with this Sunstone color as my lid color. Ta-da! All right, and then the funnest part, right? I've never done this before. You can take a really shimmery color, like the rose gold right here. So tap it in there. And then put it right on the like bulgy part of your eye, right in the middle of your lid. And it gives your eye so much dimension. All right, now I am going to, if I can find it, take my little brush. This is available from Beauty Counter. It's not in the Best of Brushes kit, but it's pretty good. I'm going to take this and I'm going to use that Moonstone that I primed with, and I'm going to use it up here. See how it goes on different with a different brush? And it's not super shimmery, so it's totally appropriate for work. Alright, then I'm going to take the same brush and use the rose gold that I highlighted the center of my eye with, and I am going to, well, I was going to highlight the corner of my eye, but that's looking weird. So I'm going to go back to the Moonstone and highlight the inner corner of my eye. You just do like a little like dash on the inner corner of your eye like that. All right, now I'm gonna take this and use a darker color, the topaz, on the corner here. And we're gonna use this in the outer corner here. And under our eye here. And blend with these dark colors. So I find for a daytime look, you know, everybody's different, but if I do any shadow on my lower lid, I find that I don't really need to line my lower lid. I am gonna go back with the Onyx and using my liner brush. This is not from Beauty Counter. I'm going to line the outside half of my eye with Onyx. Everybody's starting to get up and get moving at my house this morning. So outside of the eye with Onyx. and then I'm gonna do the inner half of my eyelid with the topaz. All right, that looks really pretty. Okay, so mascara. I like to layer the Beauty Counter Lengthening Mascara with the Beauty Counter Volumizing Mascara. I use the Lengthening Mascara first because I feel like it gives me some definition in my eyelashes. So start at the base and work out. Oh, I just poked myself in the eye. Oh, that hurt. I think I got some under my eyelid right here. Thank goodness I had extra powder under there. All right, same thing with the other eye. I don't know if you'll be able to see it because I gotta look in this mirror. Hey, I'm doing a video right now, okay? Alright, go get some breakfast, alright?
No, I need to pee.
Well, we have two bathrooms. Go to the other one.
I need to pee in here, you
squeal. And I may not put more mascara on my lower lashes. I may just let that be. So I'm gonna let that dry for a second, and I am gonna go back with the Winter Jewels palette. I'm gonna use this bronzer here. Sorry, low power. I'm gonna use this bronzer here. And I'm going to just go over where I put my bronzer before. And I'm also going to take this up the side of my face and down the side of my face. You want to imagine a backwards three. And then I'm gonna use the sunstone in the apple.
I pulled it all the way up, Mommy.
Thank you so much.
So we can see the white color.
Thank you so much.
I can go on my sweater. See you later, Mommy.
Okay, see you later.
Bye-bye.
Bye. It looks pretty. Alright, so now I'm going to go back with a layer of the volumizing mascara.
I just needed to cut in here.
Okay, thank you. Isn't that amazing? The volumizing mascara is so amazing. Oh, my hair's coming down. Okay, so the last step is your lips. Don't forget your lips. Now, if I have a lot of eye makeup on, which, I don't know, some people might not feel like this is a lot of eye makeup. I kind of do. I prefer a nude lip, especially since I'm going to work. Now, the outsides of my lips are like the same color as my skin. So I'm going to line them. This is Jane Iredale. lips. I'm gonna put a little bit of the Twig lip sheer on. Just a little bit for some color. And then this is one of the new nudes. It's called Bellini. It's a real shimmery lip gloss. And it's in the Nude Trio. And it's so pretty. And it's peppermint scented. Alright, and that was the new Winter Jewels palette, the new Illuminating Trio, the Best of Brushes set from Beauty Counter. We also did one of the nude lip glosses, and all of that is available from Beauty Counter right now. I think the palettes probably aren't going to last very long. I will put a link to my affiliate Beauty Counter site in the description below, and you should be able to find everything that we talked about today in holiday gifts. Thanks so much. I hope everybody has a great day. Bye.